Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the forward biasing of the SCR. Okay, so in the last video we have discussed about the construction of the SCR. As we know, the SCR is a 4 layer and 3 junction device. It is having a 4 layers, that is a P, N, P and N, and it is having a 3 junctions J1, J2 and J3. Okay, so before moving towards the forward biasing, let us first discuss what is the biasing. Okay, as in the PN junction diode also we have discussed the biasing. Okay, so biasing is nothing but the connection of external supply across the device. That is nothing but the biasing, simply, strictly speaking. Okay, so next let us discuss the forward biasing. Forward biasing. The SCR is said to be in a forward bias mode when its anode is more positive than that of the cathode. More positive is nothing but the its anode is at a more potential than that of the cathode. Means if the positive plate of the external supply is connected to the anode of the SCR and if the negative plate of the external supply is connected to the cathode of the SCR, then we can say that the SCR is in a forward bias mode. Okay, so let us first draw the circuit diagram of the forward biasing of a SCR. Right, as we know, this is the symbol of a SCR, the positive plate, negative plate of the external supply Vs, and suppose here the load is resistive, right, load R. This is the anode of the SCR, this is the cathode of the SCR and the gate terminal of the SCR. Okay, so here we have connected the positive plate of the supply to the anode of the SCR and negative plate of the supply to the cathode of the SCR. Okay, so can we say that the SCR is in a forward bias mode? Yes, SCR is in a forward bias mode. Okay, now from this, can we replace this symbol of the SCR with its actual construction? Yes, so we can draw the circuit, equivalent circuit, like this. As we know, in the construction of a SCR, SCR is a PNPN device. SCR is a PNPN device. So it is a 4 layer and 3 junction device. The 4 layers are P, upper layer is a P type. Next, second one is a N minus layer. Third one is a P layer. And the last one is also P layer. Okay, so here we are having the construction of the SCR. Okay, so SCR is a 3 terminal device. 3 terminals are anode, cathode and gate. Right, anode, cathode and gate. Okay, so the upper P type layer, the middle P type layer or inner P type layer and the outer N type layer, these 3 layers are having the same width. Okay, but the inner N minus layer is having a increased width or a more width compared to remaining 3 layers. Okay, what is the purpose of keeping the N minus layer as well as the increasing the width of this layer? Yes, we are interested in making our SCR to be able to block the higher voltages, right, when it is in the off state. Okay, so that's why we have added here N minus layer. This point we already discussed in the last video. Okay, now, so as we know, the anode of the SCR is connected to the positive plate of the supply, then cathode of the SCR through the load is connected to the negative plate of the supply. So here equivalently we can draw, yes, the positive plate of the supply, load and the negative plate of the supply, right? So this circuit and this circuit both are same. Okay, so let us first keep the gate terminal open circuit, right, gate terminal open circuit. Okay, so this is a plus minus Vs, okay, external supply, and the load is R. Load is having a resistance R. Okay, as we know, the P type material is having a large number of holes, okay, and it's very small number of electrons. Okay, so here when P type and N type materials are connected together, there will be a formation of junction. Okay, similar to that of the PN junction diode. Okay, so when P type and N type are connected together, there will be formation of junction. P and N type connected together, there will be formation of junction. P and N types are connected together, there will be a formation of junction. Okay. So now, yes, as we know, across a PN junction, there exists a depletion layer. Okay. So here, across three junctions, we will be having a three depletion layers. Okay. So, but for the depletion layer, at P side, we are having the layer of negative charges. Right. So we are having a layer of negative charges. I am drawing only the depletion layer. Okay. No need to draw the majority charge carriers in the P type and the minority charge carriers in the P type. Okay. So, next, at the depletion layer, at N side, we are having a layer of positive charges. Okay. So, next, at the depletion layer, at N side, we will be having a layer of positive charges. So, here it is a layer of positive charges. At P side, we will be having a layer of negative charges. Next, again at P side, across the junction, we will be having a depletion layer, and for that depletion layer at P side, we will be having a layer of negative charges, and at N side, a layer of positive charges. Okay, so here we are having the three junctions and three depletion layers. Okay. Now, so here SCR is in a forward bias mode. Okay. What is the function of the EMF? This battery is nothing but an EMF, electromotive force. Okay. The function of the EMF is to create a potential difference between the two points, as well as if the closed path is available, then it causes the circulation of the current. Okay. So let us consider the potential at the negative plate of the battery is equal to 0 volt. Okay. 0 volt. So what about the potential here? The potential here, it will be a plus Vs volt, right? This Vs, it may be anything. It may be 100 volt, it may be 200 volt, it may be 50 volt, etc. Okay. So here it is a Vs, here it is a 0 volt. Okay. Now, initially our device is in the off state because the depletion layer widths are non-zero. Okay. So device is in the off state. So when the device is in the off state, what is the current flowing through the circuit? Current flowing through the circuit will be zero. Okay, so if the current flowing through the circuit is zero, so what about the current flowing through the load? It will be zero only. Okay, so current flowing through the load is zero. So what about the voltage across the load? Definitely it should be zero. So voltage across the load is zero, meaning is the potential difference between these two points, this point and this point. Okay, potential difference is zero. Okay, so if the potential difference is zero, so can we say that whatever the potential here, the same potential will appear here? Yes. So if here it is 0 volt, definitely here potential will be a 0 volt. Okay. So if here it is 0 volt, what about here? Definitely it will be 0 volt. Here it is 0. So what about the potential at the cathode? It will be a 0 volt. Again, cathode is connected to the lower n-type layer. So can we say that the potential at lower n-type layer is equal to 0 volt? Very, very important point. Are you getting the point? Okay. So potential at the lower n-type layer is equal to 0 volt. Okay. Again, here potential is Vs. Right, so this Vs potential will appear at the anode of the SCR. Again, the anode of the SCR is connected to the P type layer. Okay, so what is the potential at the upper P type layer? Definitely it will be equal to Vs volt. Are you getting the point? This is a very, very important point. Okay, because initially the SCR is in the off state. Okay, so what about the current in the circuit? It will be zero. So voltage across the load is equal to zero. Okay, because according to the Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R. Okay. So that's why if this voltage is zero, potential here, it will be same. Okay. So zero, here it is zero, here it is zero, here it is zero. So that's why here it is zero. Okay. If this one is zero, what about here? Here it is a Vs, right? Because the function of the EMF is to create a potential difference. Okay. Potential difference means a positive plate potential minus negative plate potential. Okay. That should be equal to Vs. So it is a Vs minus zero is equal to Vs. Okay. So if this is Vs, right, so here it is a Vs. Okay, now upper P type layer potential is Vs, lower N type layer the potential is 0 volt. Okay, so can we say that from here to here, right, that is the upper P type layer to the lower N type layer, the potential goes on decreasing? Yes, because it is a Vs here, it is a 0 volt here, and across the SCR body, the total potential difference is Vs minus 0, that is a Vs. Okay, so here from here to here, the potential is decreasing. Okay, so let us consider compared to P type layer, yes, N minus layer will be having somewhat lesser potential. Okay, so consider the potential here is Vs by 3. Vs by 3. Are you getting the point? Okay. So potential here is Vs by 3. Any value you can consider, but this value should be less than that of the Vs. This value should be less than that of the Vs. Are you getting the point? Okay. Or you can consider it as a Vs by 2 also. Any value you can consider. Okay. So means here potential is Vs. Here potential is Vs by 2. That is a 0.5 Vs. Okay. I have just considered one value that is a less than that of the Vs. Okay. So next. Here potential is Vs by 2. So what about the potential here? Definitely potential here should be less than that of this potential, because the potential from upper layer to the lower layer, it is decreasing. Okay. So let us consider the potential at the inner p-type layer. It is a Vs by 3. It is a Vs by 3. Right. So it is a 0.5 Vs. It is a 0.33 Vs. Okay. So whether Vs by 3 is less than Vs by 2? Yes. Next, again from here to here, the potential is Vs by 3 minus 0. Okay. So next. Now, so here we are having the potentials are at upper p-type layer Vs. Here it is the Vs by 2. Here it is a Vs by 3. Here it is a 0. Okay. Next. Now, if we check the junction J1. If we check the junction J1. Junction J1 at P side, we are having the potential Vs. At N minus side, we are having the potential Vs by 2. So, can we say that for the junction J1, P-type potential is greater than that of the N-type potential? Yes, or P layer potential is greater than that of the N layer potential. So can we say that the junction J1 is in a forward bias mode? Yes. So very, very important. Very, very important point. Okay. So when SCR is in a forward bias mode, junction J1 is in a forward bias mode, right? So when SCR is in a forward bias mode, junction J1 is in a forward bias mode. Very, very important point. Okay. Because P type potential is greater than that of the N type potential. Okay. What about the junction J2? N minus, that is a N type layer potential is great, is Vs by 2. P type layer potential is a Vs by 3. So can we say that N type is potential great, N type potential is greater than P type for junction J2. So P type is at lower potential than that of the N type. So can we say that junction J2 is in a reverse bias mode? Is this clear? Junction J2 is in a reverse bias mode. Similarly, for the junction J3, what will happen? P type potential is Vs by 3, N type potential is 0 volt. Okay. So P type potential is more than that of the N type potential. So can we say that junction J3 is in a forward bias mode? Is this clear? Okay. So very important. They have asked the question. Please, point to be noted. Okay. When SCR is in a forward bias mode, junction J1 and junction J3 will be in the forward bias mode. Junction J2 will be in the reverse bias mode. Is this clear? Are you getting the point? Okay. Now recall the conclusion from biasing of the PN junction. As we know, in the PN junction, when PN junction is in a forward bias mode, right? When PN junction is in a forward bias mode, then what happens? Yes, the width of the depletion layer across PN junction, it goes on decreasing, right? And when PN junction is in a reverse bias mode, the width of the depletion layer goes on increasing, okay? So here, can we say that? Yes. When junction J1 is in a forward bias mode, junction J3 are in a forward bias mode. So, if we go on increasing the forward voltage, what will be happening? The widths of the depletion layer across junction J1 and junction J3, will be decreasing, right? Width of depletion layer across J1 and J3 will be decreasing, okay? But what about the width of the depletion layer across junction J2? It is a decreasing or increasing? J2 is in a reverse bias mode. So definitely the width of the depletion layer will be increasing, right? So width of the depletion layer across junction J2 will be increasing. Are you getting the point? This is a very important. Okay. So further, if we further increase the supply voltage, what will happen? The width of the depletion layer across junction J1 and J3 is decreasing. The width of the depletion layer across the junction J1 and J3 will be decreasing and it will become zero, right? It will become zero. And what about the width of the depletion layer across junction J2? The width of the depletion layer across junction J2 will be still increasing. It will be still increasing because junction J2 is in a reverse bias mode, okay? Junction J2 is in a reverse bias mode, okay? So now can we say that as junction J1 and J3 are already in the forward bias mode, okay? So we are not having any problem with the junction J1, J3 because their depletion layer width is already decreasing. but we are having a problem with the junction J2, okay, because depletion layer across junction J2 is the reason which is causing the opposition to the flow of charges through the device or for the conduction of the device. Okay, so strictly speaking, this depletion layer only, it is opposing for the conduction of the SCR. Okay, next, if we further increase the voltage, what will happen? Yes, the breakdown of the depletion layer across junction J2 takes place. Okay, and once the breakdown of the depletion layer across junction J2 takes place, then what will happen? The charges will be freely moving. Okay, means it is like our SCR will be in the on state. Okay, so very important point, very important point. When SCR is in the forward bias mode, and if the gate cathode circuit is open, when the gate cathode circuit is open, we can turn on the SCR, we can turn on the SCR, but the requirement is here we require a very high voltage. Why we require a very high voltage? Because the high voltage will cause the breakdown of the depletion layer across junction J2. Are you getting the point? This is a very important point. Okay, so next, again, in the coming videos, we'll be discussing about the turn on methods of the SCR. In that, we are having the very first method, that is a forward voltage triggering. Okay, the forward voltage triggering means what? We are going to keep the gate cathode circuit open. Okay, and we are going to apply here the high voltage, right? Why high voltage is required? Because we require a voltage that will be causing the breakdown of the depletion layer across junction J2. Okay, next. Now suppose if we are interested in turning on the SCR at a reduced voltage level, at a reduced voltage level, means suppose here we are having the lesser voltage, we are having a lesser voltage, then we need to connect the external parameters across the gate and cathode circuit. Okay, means we need to connect the one resistor, let us consider it is a RS, and one EMF, right, between gate and cathode. Okay, one EMF and one resistor between gate and cathode. So consider it is a ES, this is RS. Okay, this voltage, gate and cathode voltage, is nothing but VZ, and this current is IZ. Okay, now why we have connected this circuit? Because we are interested in turning on of a SCR to a voltage which is less than that of the, yes, the required voltage with gate current or gate cathode circuit open. Okay, so next, we are interested in turning on of a SCR to a reduced voltage level. So for that case, we have connected the circuitry or the parameters or the elements between gate and cathode circuit. Okay, now let us discuss how the gate current or how the circulation of the gate current in the gate cathode circuit will help the device to turn on at a reduced voltage level. Okay, so if you check, strictly speaking, we are not having problem with the junction J1, J3 because they are in the forward bias mode. Okay, next, when this ES is connected in the circuit, as we know, this is the EMF. Okay, this EMF consists of, at positive side, we are having the large number of positive charges. At the negative plate side, it consists of large number of negative charges. Okay, so as soon as this connection is made, then the positive charges from positive plate of the battery, right, the positive charges will try to enter into the inner p-type layer. Okay, next. So when the positive charges enters into the inner p-type layer, okay, so if you check across the junction J2, at depletion layer, at P side, we are having a layer of negative charges. Okay, so when the positive charges are entering into the P type layer, the positive charge and one negative charge, they will be recombining and gets neutralized. Okay, so when these negative charges recombines with the externally coming positive charges into the inner P type layer, whether it will help in the reduction of the depletion layer across junction J2? Yes. Are you getting the point? Okay, so what we are doing, specifically, strictly speaking, we are injecting the positive charges into the inner p-type layer. Okay, and due to the injection of the positive charges into the inner p-type layer, what is happening? One positive and one negative charge, it will get neutralized, it will recombine and it will get neutralized. Okay, and it will help in the reduction of the depletion layer across junction J2. Okay, so if this is helping in the reduction of the depletion layer across junction J2, so can we say that this is helping for the device in turn on? Yes, definitely. Okay, so one positive, one negative, it will get recombined. So therefore, ultimately, what we are getting, the width of the depletion layer across junction J2 is decreasing, right? Now, one more important point, the more the gate current, right, More the gate current means what? Current is nothing but the rate of flow of charges. Okay. More the gate current, more will be the, or the faster will be the injection of positive charges into the inner p-type layer. Okay. So faster the injection of positive charges into inner p-type layer means what? The faster will be the reduction of width of depletion layer across junction J2. Okay. So can we say that if the gate current is more, if the gate current is more, faster will be the, or the faster will be the reduction of width of depletion layer across junction J2. Okay. So if we want to turn on the SCR at a reduced flow voltage level, right, lesser voltage level, we need to circulate more and more gate current. Okay. So this is the very, very important point. Okay. So this is about, yes, the forward biasing of the silicon controlled rectifier. Point to be noted, when SCR is in the forward bias mode, junction J1 and J3 will be in the forward bias mode, junction J2 will be in the reverse bias mode. Okay. Next. As soon as we started circulating the gate current, okay, the width of the depletion layer across the reverse biased junction J2, it goes on decreasing. Okay. So in the next video, we'll discuss about the reverse biasing of the SCR. Thank you.